Hey, what's up guys? It's Rico. This is another video from the SFA vlog and I'm coming to you live from Zambia, Southern Africa. So I was born here as a kid and I moved here from to the States when I was 10 and then eventually Canada. I come back here every once in a while. This is actually the house that I grew up in till 10 years old and moved to the States. Today's video is going to be how to tell the difference between a trading company in a factory when you're going through the research phase. But before I get into that video, let me take you on a quick tour of my crib. So today's video, trading companies versus factories. So basically, some of the quick ways to tell if you're dealing with a trading company versus a factory when you're doing research on Alibaba is asking, just straight up asking them when you contact them, are you guys a trading company or are you a factory? Most of the time, trading companies will actually tell you the truth. They'll say, yes, we're a factory. Sometimes they'll lie. Another good way is to tell them quite upfront that quite early that you're going to visit them, because obviously if they're a trading company, they don't have an actual factory, they just have offices. That also weeds out trading companies very quickly. Before you even get in contact with them, when you're looking at their website, a factory usually specializes in certain products. So if you go to like an Alibaba site and you're looking at this factory and they're selling, you know, LED glasses, they're selling shoes, they're selling iPhone and Samsung covers, they're selling like random toys and stuff like that, that's probably a trading company. Factories are not going to have such a wide assortment of products unless they're kind of similar. So a good example would be like if you're dealing with a factory that is an expert in injection molding, plastic injection molding, they might have multiple products that are plastic that they're actually making themselves, but that makes sense. But if you're talking about plastic and then something else is metal and then something else is electronic, then it's probably a trading company because they work with multiple factories and can have a wide catalog. So when you're looking through that list, if you're looking through factories on Alibaba, make sure that when you click on their site, you see if they're a niche down into a certain product category or if they have multiple products from different categories, probably a trading company. Another thing is, when you like, so one of the things that we do with one of our services, a sourcing report, is we ask a factory or sourcing trading company to provide us with their business license. So the business license is usually, it's a one-page document, it has an official stamp from the government, and it usually lists out the owner or the legal representative of the company. It lists out what company it is, the name of the company, and then it also lists out what their trade is. So like I have a business license for SourceFine Asia, like a Chinese business license, has my name on it, and it says the company name, it says where we're located, when we were registered, how long our license is valid for, and what our category is. So our category would be trading consultancy. So if you, but this is all in Chinese, by the way, so like if you don't read Chinese, you're going to have somebody verify it. And then another thing is, a cool thing is, like if you scan like my business license, if I scan it from WeChat with a QR code, it'll actually pull up my official record on a government website. So that's what we do, is we'll ask them for their business license, we go through the information, and then we verify that it actually says that they're a factory, because it will say trading company or it's going to say, you know, factory. So those are some of some quick tips on how to tell the difference between a trading company and a factory from a sort of purely online and remote base. If you're physically in China, that's the number one way to do it, is just physically go there. Again, you kind of need to have a little bit of experience when you physically go there, because I've had situations, I talked about this in $2 million in 2 weeks, my fidget spinner story. We went to visit a factory, quote unquote, and it wasn't a factory. Like, it was very clear that they just moved into this place, you know, a couple of days before. So even trading companies, what they'll do if they really want to continue with this ruse is they will go to the factory that they're working with, or one of the factories that they're working with, and they'll say, look, my client is coming in, can we pretend like this is our facility? And then what will happen is, you can kind of tell, because like when you're with a trading company, like they might default to somebody else when you ask them certain questions, and then they might not know exactly, like they just might not be as familiar with the grounds that you're walking through. So like those are simple ways but you kind of have to have a little bit of experience to go through. Like, I can tell very easily, if it's your first time visiting a factory, you might be so overwhelmed by just all the stimulus that you might not be able to pick out those things. But just pay attention to body language, pay attention to whether this person seems to know where they're going, if they're familiar with the machinery, if they're familiar with the people around them, things like that. And then also check, like, if you have the company name from Alibaba, check the gate. The gate should, like, usually a factory has there's a wall, and then there's a gate, and usually the name of the factory is on the side. And then there should be, like, when you walk into the lobby, they usually have their business license up there, copies of that, even in the meeting room. So you should be able to verify that all the information is the same. The name that you found, the company name on Alibaba, is the same as the company name that you are seeing when you're physically there. And then the last step would be, like, when you start to get into payment processing, double check what bank account name you're paying to. So sometimes the name might be different, because I'll give us as an example. We have a Chinese business, registered Chinese company, and then we also have a Hong Kong company. So we have a Hong Kong bank account, and then we have a Chinese bank account. We cannot receive, because of licensing stuff, we cannot receive USD payments into our Chinese account, but we can receive any sort of currency into our Hong Kong account. So while I might invoice somebody under my Chinese company name, this just as an example, I don't do this, but like, if I invoice somebody under my Chinese company name, or if my Chinese company name was listed on Alibaba, when we get to that stage where I'm invoicing you, I might have my Hong Kong bank account listed on the invoice. So that's a situation where the name might be slightly different. But if it's a completely different name, you should ask, who am I paying to? What company is this? That, again, trading companies sometimes operate like that. They might have, you know, you pay the factory directly, and then the trading company takes their fee from the factory, pays the trading company their fee. So this is a quick overview. Like I said, if you, kind of quick ways to tell the difference between a trading company and a factory is asking, checking their business license to see if the information is correct, telling them that you're going to visit them, looking at their website, are they niche down or do they have multiple random products, and then also when you physically go there, verifying some of the information, like looking to see if they literally just moved in there or if the name of the company is the same as what you saw on Alibaba. And then when you're paying, checking the invoice to see what is the name on the bank account that you're paying to, and making sure that that's the same name as the company that you've been dealing with while setting up this order. All right, guys, so I'm signing off from Zambia, Southern Africa. I actually have a flight to China like in a few hours, so I just wanted to bang out this video really quickly. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe, drop a comment below if you have any questions, and cheers.